Hello, race fans, and welcome to the IDFRS Motorsports Network's coverage of AI Cup Lights. Round 3 brings us to Nashville. As we look at the point standings, Philip Torres won at Bristol, gaining him 9 spots, and Wilkinson, finishing second, gained 12 spots, moving them into the top 10, respectively. All right, let's see what happens at a speedway, giving our drivers a break from some short track mayhem. Let's get down to the grid. And leading our first lap is going to be... That's going to be a close one. It's going to be... 66. Followed by the 9 of Miles Hart. And then we got Phil Reed moving into third place, taking it away from Schwarzenegger. Alright, we see Douglas Terry starting to pull away slightly. And right by him, we see Group 2 starting to bunch up together, led by Matthew Hubert. We got Duke of Bruno, Lieutenant Dan, points leader Roman Malot, Shib in the 4 car, as well as Owen and Jacob Schengel, just to name a few. And right now we're focusing on Duke of Bruno and Lieutenant Dan as they're going out through turns 3 and 4. Nephew pulling away from Button, the 69 car. As we get ready to start lap 5, it's Douglas Terry, Miles Hart, Phil Reed, Schwarzenegger, Matthew Hubert. Then we have Roman Malot and Shib on the bottom lane trying to get past both Butthead and Bruno. Shib trying to hold on to position as he pulls away from Philip Torres. Some contact there between Roman Malot and Butthead crossing the start finish line. Then we got a three-way battle between Owen Shib and Philip Torres. However, Jacob Schengel decides he's going to throw himself into the mix, making it 4-wide through turn 2. And they're going to sprint away just in time. Hopefully no wreck. Still close as Raj Wolf gets brake checked by Jacob Schengel. Almost colliding with the 90 of Kelly Banks. Torres, who won last week at Bristol, currently running in the top 15. Now we're focusing on Shib and Jacob Schengel. Shib currently running in 9th with Schengel in 10th place. Moving back up, we now are seeing a battle shaping up between Duke Bruno and Roman Malot on the backstretch. Although trying to finish consistently ahead of everybody else to maintain their standings throughout the season. of are currently having one win in their career start, being the first race at Atlanta. Now, Schwartz and Gruber trying to catch up to Matthew Hubert in the 71 car. This would be a battle for fourth place. As we go further back, we'll see if Bruno has caught up to Schwarzenegger, using the momentum of the dog leg. Bruno is not really big into oval tracks, but has decided to take the initiative and understand more of these courses. Roger Wolf is just past the 96 of Owen. And as we wait for the ticker to update, we're going to see that Roger Wolf is now in 9th place, with Jacob Schengel in 10th. Looks like Shiv lost some momentum on that previous lap, driving to 11th, as Kelly Banks is coming in quickly. Then off camera, we just saw for a few seconds Brad Black in the 43 Goodrich car. Shangle's now caught up to the draft of Raj Wolf. Let's see if he can use that momentum to push him ahead of Owen. And instead, Raj is going to draft right behind Owen, leaving his position open for Jacob. And here comes Shiv digging down on the inside. He's now caught up to Jacob Schengel's draft. And it's going to be almost a tandem draft coming towards the start finish line, but Roger goes down on the apron. He's going to challenge Owen for position. However, Owen has the momentum on the outer lane. Have the 33, 99, and 93 bunched up. Battle shaping up for 5th place. So it's going to be a side-by-side battle as we start lap 14. And they're almost going to be 3 wide going into turn 1, but both Schwarzenegger and Roman Malo pull away from Duke. Romelo once again trying to pass Schwarzenegger is going to make the initiative down through turn 2. He's going to start pulling away, and caution is out. Oh, and there's a wreck with Kyle Bradley, Forrest Gump, and Skylar Taylor. Looks like Forrest Gump collided with Gutierrez, and ping pong between Skylar Taylor and Kyle Bradley. Get ourselves another angle of what happened. Like, Gump tried to pass Gutierrez, but Gutierrez just didn't give him enough room. And that's going to be 2 cars, possibly 3, taken out of the race. As we get ready to restart the race, your current leader is Douglas Terry. Green flag once again. Terry's starting to pull away, and we see Matthew Hubert challenging the 79 of Phil Reed, but backs off and is now going to have to deal with Roman Malo for 4th place. And we see another 3-way battle shaping up. This is going to be a cluster right here, being led by Kelly Banks, who's now cutting down in front of Shiv, decides to go back up and get drafting help from Duke of Bruno, as Philip Torres is cutting through in the center, passing Butthead, and is chasing after Owen. Now on the draft of Duke of Bruno, Shiv doesn't have any help. Shiv starts braking. Now Duke of Bruno's catching up to Kelly Banks, who's getting a draft from Raja Wolf. He's not allowed Duke to move into the top 10. As Kelly Banks is trying to pull away from the one car. And now we see the 33 of Schwarzenegger come into view. Here comes Raja on the offensive. Kelly Banks trying to go through the inside, is able to do so, almost hits the quarter panel of Schwarzenegger. Thankfully, doesn't go through with that. And moving into the top 10 is Philip Torres, but he gets blocked by Raja Wolf. Kelly Banks blocking Duke Bruno from passing, causing Duke to do a rake check. As we break away, we look at a running order. Douglas Terry leaves with Miles Hart in second and Phil Reed in third place. We have Roman Malot, Matthew Cooper, Jacob Schengel, Schwarzenegger, Kelly Banks, Raja Wolf, and Duke Bruno for your top 10. And now Phil Reed is looking to challenge Miles Hart for second place. Didn't have enough room on the outside, he's going to try it on the inside, going down to turn 3. Miles Hart has the momentum in the middle lane, is going to pull away from the 79 car. Now we watch Matthew Cooper catching up to Roman Malot. We're down to the last 5 laps in Nashville. Wolf now is challenging Kelly Banks for 8th place, but it looks like it might be a 3-way battle. Raja decides to duck in behind Kelly Banks. It's going to give Schwarzenegger a little bit of breathing space. And that breathing space has been temporarily disallowed. Schwarzenegger is now under pressure from Kelly Banks, who now moves into Schwarzenegger's position. And Schwarzenegger has now lost 3 spots. 4. It's going to be Kelly Banks and Raja Wolf. Here comes Shiv darting down on the inside, passing Raja. Is going to be challenging Kelly Banks for that 7th place spot. Something is up with Duke Bruno. He's just lost 2 positions, maybe 3. Here comes here the Pearson. Duke trying to use the high line. A slingshot past the 33 car. Now we see some cars slowing down. Getting ready to cut down to our last 2 laps. Romelo is caught up to Matthew Kubert and is about to pass Phil Reed for 3rd place. And Malo's gonna successfully move into the top 3 for a podium. White flag, 1 lap to go for Douglas Terry. Two more turns left to finish up his last lap. Currently 1 second ahead of Miles Hart, and our winner today at Nashville is going to go Douglas Terry. Second, Miles Hart, and in 3rd place making a comeback is going to be Phil Reed. Almost in contact there between Roman Malot and Matthew Kubert. And with the conclusion at Nashville, Douglas Terry is our winner, with Miles Hart in 2nd, Phil Reed in 3rd, points leader Roman Malot in 4th, and Matthew Kubert 5th, followed by Jacob Schengel, Shib, Raja Wolf, Kelly Banks, and Phil Torres for your top 10. The only drivers taken out of today's race was Forrest Gump, Kyle Bradley, and Skylar Taylor. As we look at the point standings, Roman Malot now has a 16-point gap from Philip Torres. Jacob Schengel now moves into third, dropping Wilkinson down to eighth. Phil Reed moves up into seventh. Kelly Banks is in fourth, Hilda Pearson in fifth. Miles Hart now in the top 10, Landrell dropping down to 10th. So it's going to be an interesting shakeup with the top 10 as they continue to fight for position heading into round 6. And with that, we'll be seeing you guys again for our coverage at Iowa on AI Cup Lights.